What's up, guys? It's been a little while, but we're back, kind of. So, a lot of things have happened in the last, I don't know, while. The van's pretty much done back there, you see. Also have another customer van, ProMaster, doing some windows and some other stuff. And we also got the Barth here. So I needed a daily driver, mainly because I'm kind of sick of having to not go through drive-thrus. And I really want a Miata, but I hate the way the new Miata looks, because if you know me, you know I like Miatas. I got the Fiat. Super happy with it. Went to Daytona Beach and got it from the dealer there. They're super cool, nice price. They have a bunch of them sitting on a lot, because apparently nobody in America wants them. But, eh, whatever. We got this ProMaster here. It's relatively new. We're doing some turnover lined windows and the sides in the back, and then doing fans on the top and a full electrical. But that's not why we're here today. Why we're here today is because we're going to install some cool parts on the Fiat. Let's see what we got. For those that know me, this is the cleanest you've ever seen my garage, and that's because I've actually turned it into a full fab slash workshop. Got the new Miller 220, super fantastic, huge welding table, all steel, on casters, good to go. Chop saw, got some work surfaces, toolbox, all the stuff you see here. It kind of makes it easier to be able to build stuff at the house and at work, because they got a lot of projects going on at work, like handrails and stuff like that, so sometimes I don't really have the room to do the work that I want to do at the time, so it pushes back my schedule a little bit sometimes, so it's nice to be able to do stuff here also. I'm super grateful for being able to have the stuff at work, but you know, I don't want to interrupt those guys. Like, that's kind of a shitty move to do, to make them move everything all the time. So this kind of makes it a nice balance. But that's not what we're talking about here. What we're talking about now is the Go Fast Bits. This is the Diverter Valve Plus. Now, based on what I can figure out, stock diverter valve, apparently, it releases pressure too quick or something, or leaks. I don't know. All I know is that it's supposed to hold boost better, and in between shifts, it doesn't let off the boost as fast, so you get better sustaining of the boost from your turbo in between shifts when you let off and the diverter valve is supposed to open, this and that. I guess it holds just a hair longer and makes it that much better. Plus the no leaking makes it great. That's the box. That's pretty. Apparently there are some fakes of these out here, so make sure you buy them from a reputable source. I got this from Goodwin Racing. I'll put the link in the description below. But there's a couple good places. Euro Compulsion and those kind of guys. It's a fairly simple package, and it has instructions, which are actually pretty good. Shows you all you need to do. Basically, you take your old diverter valve off, you take it apart. It comes with a spring that replaces the factory one, a cat that replaces it, as well as a spacer unit. And this goes inside your diverter valve, and the actual plate, as well as three longer screws. Not very happy that these are not stainless, but we all know the weird fetish that I have for stainless, because, well, I work for builderstainless.com. So we're gonna go pull the old one off the car and put this on. So this guy right here is what we're gonna take off. It's gonna be one connector and three Allen head bolts. Thank you. Alright, so this is the diverter valve here. Just kind of... that's interesting. Found a little rotational pivot thing here. That spring goes out. I believe we have to... read the instructions. We gotta pull the sleeve out of the body. And then this whole thing has to come out. And I believe that this is discarded. So that goes out, and then, alright, so this is your diverter valve. We're going to put the supplied spring from the kit onto there, and then take the plunger, put it in there, then take this guy, put it right there. And then this is going to go here with the piston on top. Now, the one thing that you want to make sure of here is that the O-ring right here is installed. You can see it right there. Now, the only thing that you need to be aware of before you drop it in is there's this little tab here. This little tab right here. And there's a slot in the diverter plus to put right there. So you got to make sure that's lined up, otherwise it's gonna sit cattywampus. So put that in, make sure everything's set, and then let's put her back on. And that's it, it's done. It literally took like 18 minutes to do the whole thing. So, I'm not really gonna do a video on what it sounds like, cause whatever. This is more of a functional mod for later on, when I add the Euro compulsion tune, the exhaust, and all this other stuff to handle the higher boost better. That being said, there's gonna be a lot of mixed stuff on the channel now. We're gonna be doing more with the van very soon. I've gotta start putting the windows in. We need to get this thing done, get it back to its lovely owner so she can start on the build out. And then I have another transit coming in to do some stuff on that. There's just gonna be a lot of mixed up stuff going on. Stay tuned with us and have some fun. We got the exhaust coming in for this guy. We got the Goodwin Racing exhaust and the resonator is super duper loud, hopefully. It's gonna be nice and burbly and all that kind of jazz. That should be here on Saturday. We'll do a quick video for that. Sunday or Monday, we're gonna do some really good like sound comparisons for stock versus with the exhaust. Stay tuned, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like, all that jazz. Still on Instagram, Sprint Van Gogh. That's not gonna change. We're just adding more fun to the stable, so thanks for hanging out, guys.